Well, we've made a lot of progress on one front and much less progress on another. The front we've made a lot of progress on is simply understanding basic human biology and also the biology of the little animals that whose genes we can alter, and that's a sort of prelude to understanding what happens in humans. So the basic science has just been transformed by the human genome.
So it advanced biology exponentially.
Right. So almost everything you do in a lab, you now sort of refer to the genome in one way or another. You fish out genes in just a few seconds at your computer that would have taken you 5, 10 years beforehand. So all of biology has been transformed and accelerated by the Human Genome Project. But where we've had less success is in ferreting out the roots of common human diseases, which was one of the goals of the project. In fact, it was a formal goal of the project. And sooner or later, it should indeed help us understand the genetic basis of disease. But as of right now, the principal approach that we tried, that we placed our hopes in for finding these variant genes, has been largely disappointing.
Disappointing because in the search, with all that we have learned, the search for the causes, the genes that cause diseases, we've run into more of a challenge than we imagined.
Yes, we had a game plan, a theory. It was a very reasonable theory and a very logical one, but it was wrong.
What was the theory?
The theory was called the common variant, common disease theory. So the idea was that the common diseases of old age are caused by variant genes that are common in the population. And the reason they got to be common is that natural selection protects us and keeps us very healthy up to the age we bear children and a little bit beyond as parents. But beyond that, its power to save us from bad things is sharply diminished, because it all depends on how many children you get into the next generation. And once you've had your children, natural selection cares much less about you. And that was how these bad variant genes, the theory held, got to be common. So the strategy in the Human Genome Project was to look through the genome of many people in different populations, look at all the sites where there's common genetic variation, and then compare patients with healthy people and see if you could make a link between the common variants and diseases. So this approach, it was called a genome-wide association study, was going to find all these common variants, explain to us the genetic basis of all these bad diseases of old age, and that would allow us to develop drugs and treatments for each of them. So it was a very logical theory, but nature has not cooperated with it. Nature proves to be a lot more complex.
And complex in one part because they found that a lot more genes affecting disease than we imagined.
That's right. They found a few genes behind these diseases, but these genes explain typically just 5% of the genetic burden of the disease. So that led to the problem of what's called the missing inheritability. What was causing the other 95% of the risk? Now, all this became clear really quite recently, just the last sort of 6 months or so.
What made it become clear?
That we'd had all these genome-wide association studies performed by universities and medical centers all over the world. They're all very expensive, but everyone rushed into them because they believed this was the royal road to finding these genes and the treatments. And in the last 6 months, with almost every major disease investigated by a genome-wide association study, it's clear that we've only explained a very small fraction of the burden of disease by looking at these common variants.
Join us online at charlierose.com.